as relaxed as I might have expected to see him.
Well, he's a little tight, and he has every right to be, because this is a big step for him to grab four titles. It's really a big accomplishment.
This fight is being televised back to Nicaragua. So although he is in exile, he is still a great hero in his country.
We're going to have a couple of national anthems here. We will have the Nicaraguan national anthem, and we will also have, of course, the national anthem of the United States. So we will still be a few moments, and actually I can't help again but wonder if this isn't a strategy employed by Aaron Kleierskamp, that Alexis Arguello is going to have to stay around for quite a while.
Well, after you've had 80 fights, I don't think anything that they can do in the ring can budge.
He did make an interesting comment after he knocked out Kevin Rooney, which really was his first fight at the 140-pound weight. He said, "I think I did good." He said, "But I'm not 100% sure I can handle 140 pounds. And I'd say that's a pretty candid comment.
Well, you have to remember that originally he was a featherweight. And then he fought for the longest time as a junior lightweight. And then he outgrew that division. He is tall, 5'9", so he can handle the additional weight. Now he's at a weight that's somewhere between lightweight and welterweight. But again, I think it's worth repeating that he's probably the best lightweight in the world, simply fighting above the lightweight limit.
Well, the festivities go on here in the Orange Bowl before the entrance of Aaron Pryor into the ring. Fireworks going on, and because of some legal goings on here, Aaron Pryor could not come out until the fireworks had ended. We mentioned that there is an undercurrent of a volatile situation here at Miami, and I suppose enough said about that, but a fact is a fact, and that right now is a fact. Alexis Arguello will face a fighter who will come right at him, a tough fighter who will come right at him in Aaron Pryor, and if you're wondering, has he fought that type before? Yes, he has. Fought a fellow by the name of Art Hafey who came right at him. He knocked him out in the fifth round. Chico Aparicio, household name, who he decisioned twice over 15 rounds, and then, of course, most recently, Boom Boom Mancini, who he knocked out in 14 rounds, but not without a struggle.
A lot of people were surprised by that, even though that was a wonderful fight, a truly wonderful fight. There are some boxing observers who felt that that showed that he was in some decline, that he couldn't handle the rather primitive, straight-ahead Mancini a little bit more easily than he did.
Well, Aaron Pryor making his way to the ring now with disco music blaring through the speaker systems here and all around, and he's the kind of guy who, without question, gets himself pumped for
a fight. He's really psyched up, but I see his face, and Pryor, he's perpetual motion, straight ahead, and relentless attacker. He's going to go straight out.
Asprilla, who he knocked out in the 10th round, he averaged, and I think this is truly remarkable, 100 punches per round. So Aaron Pryor makes his way toward the ring now and is about to step into the ring through the ropes. And that is a question that has been asked time and again. What time is it? Aaron Pryor's handlers will say, hot time. Pryor comes into the ring, bouncing around, wearing the championship belt. His trainer trying to clear some of the traffic. And Lewis kind of egging on Alexis Arguello. There is the record of Aaron Pryor. 31 wins, no losses, not a draw, 29 knockouts. He has had to go the distance only twice, and neither one of those times was he ever in any real danger. And the last time he had to go the distance was back in 1977. So he comes to fight, and he doesn't have to do it for a long period of time. As you see, Arguello, 3 years the senior of Aaron Pryor. He is 3 inches taller than Aaron Pryor. He gives away a pound and a half, a couple inches in reach, but I think age could be the only factor that would be an appreciable difference. Right now, let's go up to the ring announcer, Hector Salazar, for the introductions of the fighters and the anthems.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, silence, please. Silence, please. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Please rise. Señoras y señores, por favor, un minuto de silencio. Vamos con los himnos. Silencio, por favor. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the Nicaraguan and the United States national anthem. The United States national anthem will be seen by Gloria Estefan, lead singer of one of the top groups in this country, Central and South America, Miami Sound Machine.
We await the singing of the national anthems of both Nicaragua and the United States here. A little bit of confusion right now. And of course, the fighters have to stand around and wait. That's always a factor because they come into the ring warmed up, I think. You see the lacing on of the gloves.
Su atención, por favor. May I have your attention, please?
All these delays are a reflection of the fact that the people promoting the live gate here have never promoted a fight before. They all have themselves on the line here. They have their reasons for putting on the fight. They've paid a lot of money for this stage, and by God, they're going to use it.
Well, the stage does not yet belong to the fighters. It belongs to a whole bunch of other people right now. And
State of America.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the
We will still have the Nicaraguan anthem yet to come here.
And now, the Nicaraguan national anthem.
Tal vez a ti, Nicaragua, en tu suelo. Se tiñe con sangre de hermanos
tu glorioso pendón bicolor. Ni se tiñe con sangre de hermanos tu glorioso pendón bicolor. Hermosa la paz en tu suelo, nada empañe tu gloria inmortal, el trabajo.
at hand being taken care of. We now have but to get getting with this ongoing fight here, which is seeming to be ongoing for about 20 minutes so far. And we've yet to have the first punch throw.
In this corner, from Coral Gables, Florida, formerly from Managua, Nicaragua, three-time world champion, actual WBC lightweight champion of the world, with the record of 76 and 4, including 61 knockouts, weighing 138 and a half pounds, Mr. Alexis Arguello. Was the white champion of the world, undefeated in 31 fights with 23 consecutive knockouts, weighing 130 pounds, Adam Pryor. 15 rounds, si llega.
Well, Hector Salazar getting more airtime than the three of us as you look at Aaron Pryor, and he is a man intense right now, Ray.
Well, he's really sucking himself out. I guarantee, well, I can't guarantee anymore, but I feel this been knocked down early. Salazar's gonna get hurt. How about you, Larry?
I think the most crucial thing in the first round or first two rounds is whether Arguello can use his great ability as a body puncher, and many people think he's one of the greatest body punchers there ever was, to slow up the charge of Aaron Pryor.
Aaron Pryor has been known to charge out at the opening bell. Round one. Pryor with the first punch. He stills with the right hand. Up tempo right from the opening bell.
Well, I wouldn't be surprised if someone gets knocked down the first round.
Now, perpetual motion is right on top of Arguello. That's off the ropes.
Body was able to hurt Pryor for a while,
which is exactly what Larry Mitchell was just mentioning.
Those uppercuts by Alex and that overhand right is very effective in Pryor's style.
Pryor is now slowed down just for the moment. Pryor has been knocked down. He will say, yes, I've been knocked down. I'll take a count of 1, 2, or 3. And my opponent will get knocked down and take a count of 8, 9, or 10. That has been the story. First round, up the counter, right hand. For the first round of a 15-round fight.
Both fighters a little tight.
And right hand by Arguello.
This is the first time that I haven't seen Alex go at this pace in a early round.
There's a right hand by Pryor, and Arguello is hurt. Well, so far the fight has been exactly as advertised.
He started to buckle back. as they started off very fast and began the first round.
When there weren't too many who expected this fight to go the difference in distance, rather than up here by Pryor again. And at this pace, there is simply no way that it can. Combination by Pryor. And an uppercut. Into the round, and what a first round.
A very, very big round for Aaron Pryor. And the important thing there was he continually to the punch. Let's take a look at some of those exchanges early on. He wasn't giving Aguayo a chance to breathe, but he set himself to throw the punch. Aguayo likes to set himself to throw his punches. There you saw a left come right through Aguayo's guard. Aguayo was continually backing up. And another exchange later in the round.
Keep those hands up good. Move a little more.
There you saw two punches, three, a very good left hand. Aguayo was simply getting licked to the punch. A five-punch exchange that Aaron landed on.
Another factor also is the fact that Pryor often misses shots. He did not miss many punches, and that first round was scores.
From either fighter, someone has to go down.
Both men were hurt in the first round. Pryor early, but Aguayo got much the worst of it. And again, Pryor getting off before Aguayo. Aguayo, professional, and that is a thing that is constant. When you hear anybody talk about Alexis Aguayo, they say he's the consummate professional.
Well, see, Pryor always punch himself out, and so he put a lot of energy up. He must keep
watch
him down. He can't stand straight up. By that hit by Aguayo, just land. Pryor can't afford to stand straight up because Aguayo gets very good leverage. But inside, it should be Aaron Pryor.
Aguayo got a right hand counter punch out. Pryor is hurt.
Now, see, you see Aguayo, his Pryor was dazed from that overhand right.
Pryor talking to Aguayo now.
Stop.
Keep him in there.
What's up?
Pryor draws a warning for hooking.
He's been rough by Pryor, but see Pryor's mistake. And what happens is that he burned his stamina as hard as good as it should be. Although he punches very, very hard, things to do.
Well, this fight so far is exactly as all the promotional releases have said. That's a rarity. I've seen it a couple of times, once in your fight with Tommy Hearns, but it is rare that a fight lives up to the press clippings. So far, this one has. Still right on that one.
Right hand underneath.
There it is. A straight right hand. Right hand, right to the point of the chin.
Right down downstairs.
Interestingly
enough,
Aaron Pryor came right back after.
All right? Go. You're the boss now, Jeff. Give me that drink, man, that I mix. One that I mix. Lose the clue. Mix it. Call us up. You're the boss now. Roll!
Jab, roll! Alright? Jab to the head, right under the body. Up, go! Bring the throat, roll!
Panama Lewis wants Pryor to move his head more and move his body more, not coming quite so straight to our ground.
We can't afford to, though, because, again, Alex gets such good leverage on his punches. His punches are so hot. So I have to be very careful. Both Pryor's head on early on here. Should be with the left hand, the right hand. It's going to be unfortunate.
We got a double jab. You can beat this motherfucker, you can eat him with a jab.
Right, followed by a left jab that missed, and a right that grazed the chin of our grab. Still coming on. Another left that lands.
Okay,
obviously,
all right. Talk to me, champ. Just talk to me. Put down your left. All right? Double jab with this sucker. Double jab. All right? Because when you shoot one jab, it's kind of punching you. So double the jab. Double jab, right hand. Okay? Okay? Come on.
You the boss.
All right? Yeah. Vaseline, Vaseline. Good. Come on, come on, come on, come on. You the boss, yeah. Come on.
Work that left jab, get inside.
I would tend to agree with Mark. I don't really think there is any arm willingness on the part of Pryor. Both of them really seem to have their legs under them, too. And that, of course, is the real tell.
They both down the field.
Thank you. He's throwing up. Keep the pressure on.
Vamos arriba y pon las combinaciones de 4 o 5 golpes. No te quedes en un solo golpe, ¿ok? Hazlo con el jab.
Come on, boxing, you got the leg. Come on.
Pryor again rushing after Stewart and Alexis Arguello. Arguello being told to keep the jab in his face. Swelling does not really look to be very much worse than it was when it happened. So.
Confianza. Tú tienes que iniciar rally de 4 o 5 rounds. Tú abres con el jab. Tú abres con el jab. Y termina con 4 o 5 golpes. No esperes por él.
Is not like the
impressive to see Aaron Pryor as a boxer. Punches. He throws the overhand right, then follows that right hand with the straight back left jab.
Yeah.
And the brother's going to find out.
Yeah.
get yourself to the gym. Yeah, because you're standing there. Well, you're not fucking up. You can jump right to the body. Right, just keep taking off in the gym. But be first. Don't stand up there. If you stand up there, you're going to see it
the other way. That right hand got in high in the head. Way of grazing prior there. Now you'll see prior comes in. Four punches.
That was the
second good round in the row for Ray.
Now you cut that out or I'll send your wife in the corner here.
Stanley Christa due to warning Panama Lewis for coaching. And the warning of very vehement.
Proposition as Larry Merchant sees it.
All right, cut it out, that's enough.
Just a little precipitous to talk to Pryor's corner. Pryor trying to work on the eye. There is no blood showing right at the moment. There's a right hand by Aguayo. And Pryor backs up for the moment. And another right hand by Aguayo. Pryor does not seem to be hurt. Hurt Pryor. He's not really connected.
As long as Pryor stands there for a while, then moves, you notice a will can get set.
Pryor back up on the motion of his own. Blood still is stopped.
Pryor should walk away at this point here. At least he's got a rope. As far as that he did.
Both men at this point are highly capable of going 15 rounds should it become necessary.
Aguayo's trying to put the pace up now.
Aguayo misses a round over there. Aguayo's not missed it. He's been thrifty with his
straight right hand okay. Earlier in the round.
You lost that round because you don't keep your head down.
Landed.
Okay,
we got three
rounds
of those. Let's take a look at it. A body
okay.
Shot followed by a right hand under and over.
Jab, jab.
That is the sign of a very great fighter.
Left hook, side to side.
Both the thrower and throwee.
You got to win this three rounds. Big, full limb, side to side. All right? Wake up. Hold this here.
Touch the mouth, please.
Let's go, baby. Let's go. You are the world champion. All right.
As you see it now, the fight's dead even.
It's just about dead even, yes.
And the pace picking up considerably.
All right.
As you see it now, the fight's dead even.
It's just about dead even, yes.
And the pace picking up considerably. Pryor off the stool and right in Alexis Aguayo's lap.
This fight is incredible. Bombs the whole time.
Superb condition. Excellent. Uppercut by Blair.
Should have taken any man out.
Still still trying to work, or rather, Pryor trying to work on the eye of Arguello. It's still swollen, and a little bit of blood shows underneath the eye, but not so much above it is where it could cause him more problems. There's a good right hand by Pryor. Another tremendous round.
Just seeing two championship stallions come down the home stretch here. And they're just going head to head.
It's very good that round. Can you keep it up for two more rounds?
Look and see that.
6 minutes and you're champion still, but you gotta win the round.
Whack, batting practice.
Gotta win these two rounds.
Where Aaron Pryor gets that reservoir of strength and spirit, it just seems as deep as the Ohio River.
Give me another thing. Give me another bottle. The one I mix.
Yeah.
Okay?
Come on.
I gotta win these two rounds, champ. No. All right, wait a minute. Here, 6 minutes.
One more time from another angle, and it'll hurt just as much.
He's tired now.
This angle here.
Okay?
His snap back.
You got to punch back. Win these two last rounds. 6 minutes. You can fight for 6 minutes. We go all day in the gym. We go all day in the gym, all right? You work hard now. Come on.
Neither one of you could hurt each other, even though you were hitting so hard. Did you feel that he was getting weaker?
Yes, I did. But, you know, he was always dangerous, always doing the fight. You've seen that by those devastating right hands he was throwing.
But, Let's go, champ. We gotta go.
Later rounds, you know, I knew that I would come on victorious. But my trainer, Panama Louis, did a great job. Curly.
Let's check out Guayo.
I'm happy that I proved to the people. Let me go meet the champion. Let me go talk to the champion of the world.
Let's go. We got a long way to go.
All right, back to ringside.
Okay, thank you very much, Larry Merchant. And all of a sudden, it is just like that. It is over. It was starting to look as though we were going to have a decision that really could have gone either way. And just in an instant, it was Aaron Pryor just all over the three title holder, Alexis Arguello. Let's take another look at just how it ended, Ray.
Well, Aaron Pryor just came on strong. I don't know where he got the energy from. He hurt Arguello with that overhand right, and you see here, he just stayed on top of his man. I felt Arguello could come back because he's very defensive fighter, but there's just too many punches thrown by Aaron Pryor. That right hand did the most damage in that round.
And that was just one of many. But again, you can't emphasize enough what an intelligent fight he fought. He came into this fight with a reputation just as a brawler. And he said, I'm just going to come at the guy, and I'm going to throw 100 punches around. And if 10 of them land,
well,
that's
that right
enough.
Hand there, Barrett, and that, the second right hand was a punch that really did a number, but with a left hook that was partially blocked. And again, another overhand right by Pryor. Pryor, he's just a machine. Perpetual motion.
Well, after watching the films of Aaron Pryor and seeing him over the years, I really, to be very honest with you, just thought of him as just a brawler. Well, he proved that he was much more than just a brawler and was more than a worthy champion.
Well, now you can really see some of the punches. I mean, the power of Aaron Pryor. He gets inside and he stays there. He did the right thing. These two guys, I really didn't expect this fight to go the distance or at least 14 rounds. And Aaron Pryor shows so much will and determination and skill, if anything.
So Aaron Pryor retaining his junior welterweight championship. And right now you kind of have to look and say, what's next for this guy? Does he step up? Does he go down? He really could fight either as a welterweight or as a lightweight, and maybe is even more effective as a lightweight.
Well, we see here that Arguello is completely out of it. Aaron Pryor, he has the strength of a welterweight. I'm really, you know, I think words cannot describe, I mean, the way how much I'm impressed with both fighters. I mean, Pryor, I think what he should do now is go and soak up all the recognition he can, because he deserves everything now. This fight with Arguello brought out the true Aaron Pryor.
Well, we talked about hungry fighters, and I don't think there's any question but that virtually from the day he lost to Howard Davis in the 1976 Olympic trials, he has been a hungry fighter. Larry?
Incidentally, Pryor was ahead on two of the three officials' cards by 2 and 3 points, which more or less jibed with my card. Of course, if that last round would have gone the distance, it would have been a two-point round for Pryor, so he was going to win the fight one way or another, but he made it rather decisive.
Panama Lewis, of course, told him he had to win the last two rounds. Talk about winning it, he won the last round real big, and the last one was the 14th.
And of course, that should stir up some memories for you, Ray. The 14th round, much as Holmes did when he had too late in the fight against Cooney, much as you did against Hearns.